Hello viewers, I'm SB and welcome back to Total War Warhammer. This right here is the situation. Abrash von Karstein just got promoted. When we settle things down and reform the proper empire, this dude is head general for life, which means forever. Because who could possibly kill him after this performance? So I think we gotta refill his army and push after these guys. We cannot let them escape. He has earned some chillgeists, I think, and then some skeletons. You know, he does good work with just random garbage units. Oh, I didn't actually press the recruit button on the... Okay, there we go. This better be important. Alright, go. Chase him. No escape. Sertha of the Kvelig, Felman Ingerson, and Carl Groven. The game thinks that they can win this. I don't agree. Let's get in there and handle it. I can't believe they're willing to stand and fight me, frankly, after what just happened. And back, and what just happened refers to a thing where I didn't have even a single ghost. Now my army's chock full of them. Also, I know that the battle markers appearance, the appearance of the battle markers, is based on the number of dead. But it's kind of crazy that, like, a lot of humans and zombies falling in combat can make a Vargulf corpse show up. Like, the intensity of the battle should have something to do with it. And I feel like the game should have been able to sense that that last thing was a really intense battle. Whatever. We'll be fine. We'll take these guys out really quickly, I think. And then we'll take out his reinforcements really quickly, and we'll just chase him into the north. This is Abrash von Karstein's life now. Until such time as we can get the von Karstein Empire firmly reestablished, he is unfortunately going to be consigned to trekking around the north murdering Norscans. But, you know, it's not the worst thing that could happen. He could be stuck in the mountains fighting dwarves forever. At least the scalings have the common decency to die when you kill them. Freaking dwarves just, like, stand through everything. Do I want to put the feasters and the chillgeists just, like, right up here and just ram him? Because, like, these chillgeists, being ethereal, are basically immune to his everything, would be my guess. I bet Sertha of the Kvelig doesn't even have so much as a magical weapon to his name. Now, let's stay together. Let's not let anything silly happen. Sure, we'll gamble. See if we can start with a little bit more magic. Just so that I can be a little aggressive with my spellcasting. Wait, how do you do the... I thought you could alt-click and have the guys keep formation. But it is not what is happening. Right, this army doesn't have any ranged units, right? I don't think that they have any ranged units. So I'm basically just going to run the Vargas over here and see if I can panic them. Who's spooked? I'm terrifying. Make sure everybody's moving fast. This is not having any effect. It's fun to do, though. Okay, time to fall back. They're bringing in marauders who could throw axes at us. Alright, I think we can basically just lead with the vampires here. I don't really want to spend the time to form up. What I do want to spend the time to do is drop some spells. So my suspicion is that they will bail upon seeing this. Have our general meet their general nobly on the field of battle. Do I want to ride the Chillgeists? I guess the Chillgeists can attack marauders. My horrors versus their trolls should be pretty easy for us. And then all the rest of you guys, you slow guys, just get in here. Double time. Oh, you should probably, like, be ready to join battle. Nope, they just stood there and let the purple sun form on top of them. Please don't wander into the chill wraiths. Oh no, it's doing it. It clipped him at the end there. It took a little damage. Yeah, and then all of their... the thing about the Norscan forces is that there's a lot of them, and some of them are kind of fast. But the ones that are fast are also the worst, like, the worst ones. I am so not afraid of these dogs and chaos marauders. I guess the chariots are maybe a little scary. Oh, hold up, let's get an invocation onto these guys. I'm surprised at how much damage they're taking, considering that they are Oh, you know what though? They're ethereal, but they have their morale's all screwed up, so they're crumbling. Okay, crypt ghouls. Let's have our ghouls engage. A unit of ghouls can take a unit of dogs pretty quickly, I would think. See if you can swamp this chariot a little bit. And I'm going to drop a quick unit of the dead over here. Wow, that really does not have much range. Just try to give the... Oh, that's right. I didn't actually give him time to finish casting invocation. Okay. Now we'll drop some dead guys. Just give them a... try to give these guys a reasonable chance for escape. Okay, their morale's filling back up. Get him. Now, invocation has a pretty short cooldown. Hopefully it'll be available again soon. Understood. We'll use her immortal will to get some HP back. At once. Go ahead, fight them. Actually, we just have a bunch of dudes just kind of sitting around here. Alright, zombies are doing a pretty good job of keeping the chaos trolls in place while we do the more important units get to them. The chill rates are really dedicated to their job. Alright, well, this is going pretty well so far. Yep, unit of zombies has fallen. Let's get everybody over here. Sure, go fight them. I'm sure that will go fine. Let's just ball up on these guys. Now, I'm not going to get, I think, another opportunity for a Wind of Death quite like the one we had before, but this isn't bad. If I can just get over to here. Unfortunately, he's stuck on something, it seems like. Okay, hold up. So I want to shoot it, like, here. Now stop moving, you're screwing up the angle. Yeah, that's pretty good. That was pretty okay. Okay, it does not have infinite range. It's not a ray just continuing infinitely into the distance. That's a shame. Alright, somebody make sure that these chaos trolls actually go down. Let's turn my other chaos trolls around, fight these great weapon dudes. I have to say, like... Do an overcharged invocation of Nahek right around here. We'll clip those guys. Oh, I guess they're at their regen limit already. But like, it's so hard to kill my units. Where are you guys going? it's so hard to kill my units because we just have so much health. Like, every one of my units effectively has the hit point, the regen cap, in every single battle, it feels like. Now that we have all of this stuff that, you know, our heroes regen on, cause map-wide regen on casting, and wow, is this unit of Skeleton Warriors actually holding off this many guys? That's crazy. Let's try to make sure that these trolls actually get wiped out. You guys probably don't have to get involved with that. Somebody needs to finish off these marauders. It doesn't need to be a corpse cart, though. Yeah, easy. I don't think, I don't think that was even close. Yeah, the game even says decisive. Now, I lost control of this vampire. She wandered off during the battle, and it seems like she may have gotten seriously injured or perhaps killed. I don't feel great about that. This is what happens when I pause less often, trying to keep the battle moving. I end up losing track of stuff. And I know that on the highest difficulty, you can't pause in combat, so that's going to be a problem for me. My micro just isn't there. I never was any good at real-time strategy games. So, Sertha of the Kvelig has basically no units left. Karl Groven has basically no units left. The command of the Scaling Forces now falls to Felman Ingerson, and I don't know a lot about the lore, but I've certainly never heard that name before. My suspicion is, we don't have to be concerned about him. So, gosh, I hope this vampire's not dead. I hope she just fled or something. Because she was a death vampire with a fully upgraded lore. It would be really nice if she was still around. The Purple Sun is pretty cool. Although, now that we know how, okay, yeah, she's still alive. The Dominate Captors thing gives her a little bit of health. If she was actually dead, that wouldn't be the case. Okay, so we'll go ahead and Dominate Captors. We successfully eliminated the following lord in battle. I guess we killed him during the fight. That's a pretty good sword. We should check real quick. What weapons do we have? I guess we should also give Aberash some more. Okay, next turn he gets a, next level he gets a Hellsteed. Man, that zombie dragon sounds really good. So do I think I want to give him some redline skills, maybe? He seems to be the greatest commander of all time. He's unstoppable. Graveguard and Crypt Horrors, Ethereal Unit Speed and Charge Bonus. Fargeist and Terror. You know, this stuff's not really for him. Yeah, I guess let's just really lay on the melee ability. Well, we could go to the blue line. What does the blue line have for us? Big replenishment rate bonus. In case you're unclear, this is not plus 3% of your old casualty replenishment rate. It's not like 103% of the base replenishment rate. This is plus 3% of the unit's maximum HP replenished every turn. So at max rank where it's 15, it actually like will almost always take a turn or maybe even two off of your replenishment times. So why don't we go for that? Because we're doing a lot of fighting and a lot of chasing. Obliterate. Two more percent replenishment, or I mean, we can take the leadership buff, I guess. I don't think we really need it. He's untrustworthy. Why does he get untrustworthy after winning fights? We had that happen to another one of our lords as well. Oh, I was going to check everybody's weapons and make sure everybody's, like, reasonably equipped. Let's finish upgrading your hit points, I guess. And you also could maybe use some hit points. Let's get you a little physical toughness. Okay, so Aberash's weapon is what? He has a Shrieking Blade, which causes him to cause fear and terror. That's fine, I guess. Let's see, we also have an open slot in his entourage. It looks like the only thing we have available is banners. Sure, you can have a banner of swiftness to put on somebody. That's probably probably useful. So do vampires not naturally cause fear? He's such a good fighter, though. I think I'm going to go for the obsidian blade. This vampire, who I think does not naturally cause terror. She causes fear. Yeah, so the shrieking blade is basically causes terror. That's not horrible. Makes people rout when she's fighting them, but it doesn't work against people who cause fear themselves, right? No, fear-causing units are immune to fear, terror-causing units are immune to terror. Okay, well, yeah, sure. Let's make her even better at fighting. Apparently we still have some unequipped physical resistance. That'll be good. Potion of Toughness. Oh, we have a spare Forbidden Rod. This is definitely going on you. Try to keep my caster abilities on my casters so that I remember where they are. And she's not wearing any armor or anything. This might have something to do with what happened. Sort of swift slaying. Give you some... And I can't imagine fire resistance is meaningful, like, at all. Sure, let's lower our raised dead costs. Okay, we did it. Now the tower? Yeah. Here's what I think of your tower. Just gonna cleanse the whole place. So somebody told me that when you see the dead rise again, it means one of your undead units that fell during the battle just respawns in your employ. That's pretty cool. So we'll do the old sack and raise. Sack it one turn, raise it the next. Apparently Morsleeb shines. That's the green moon, right? That's the bad one? The one we don't like? I think turning him into a flying unit is probably a pretty good idea. So she's, like, in really bad shape. I kind of don't want to end my turn in their territory. We can move back to here and get a turn of replenishment and then finish, go back to crack and burn it down. But I wanted to siege it and get all that money first. Because having all this money is going to be very helpful. Alright, let's start building the walls. Even if we burn all of the northern tribes' lands, I'm still not going to feel safe if we can't get walls around our settlements. Alright, upgrading Fort Ostrock is not as important. Castle von Rocken is kind of in the middle of everything. I wouldn't feel so bad about that. Being left alone. Let's jump back to Pierre. So, alright, Eilhart and Grunberg both need to be upgraded to level 3. I guess Eilhart's going to be on the front of the war with Marienburg, so let's prioritize that one. What are we going to do about these assholes? If I wanted to get in the water, really, right here is the only place to get in the water? Is Eilhart not a port? I guess, no, it has a, oh no, this is not Eilhart. Well, yeah, I really don't know what to do about these guys. They're going to play keep away with us until we can get a second army down here, basically. We can chase them all day, but they can run away from us just as fast as we can run after them. Okay, Valdekir is keeping Prague locked up. Volksgrad should probably build a fence. Where's Bertha? Bertha has not managed to successfully assassinate... Oh no, she killed Sarthak, that's right. What is her next job? We get after these scalings, but, like, I don't think we need to, probably. Because we can just kill them this way. You know, the old-fashioned way. One 1% replenishment doesn't really sound that great. I'll take the buff. We don't need the replenishment. The only unit that's not going to be at full health is some zombies, it looks like. Plus 3 attack for war beasts, monstrous infantry, and giant units. That's probably... It says monstrous infantry, war beasts. Does that include things that are just marked as monster? Wow, what is going on here? Why does she have a liar, a deceiver, a fault witness? What does this stuff have to do with, usually you gain traits that are somehow based on what you've been doing. Strange. So we were leveling up Isabella's close combat abilities, it looks like. I think I decided I don't want to put him on a corpse cart, because that'll make it even harder to land Wind of Death. Which means he needs to keep leveling his magic, I guess. There's not really anything else to do. You get Prime Mover, which will let him at least increase the income of buildings in his region, but he's going to tend not to be in regions that have a lot of money stuff, because, first of all, I think Isabella has that trait we just got, and secondly, you know, we need this army to go around and kill people. So I guess I'll just level up my spells. It's the only useful thing I can think of to do with him. Alright, Vlad can get out of march mode and can start harassing these guys.
Sleep is for the living.
Really? The game doesn't think that we're gonna blow this away. Well, okay, I'll do it manually. I think at this point, I've gotten, okay at fighting as vampires. I'm starting to understand the application of the units and everything. I do believe that we have broken the threat that is the Varg. Now, clearly this Varg dude thinks that he's not going to win, because he retreated. So I'm curious why the game thinks that that auto-resolve, or that balance of power bar was accurate, because if that was accurate, it was more red than it was yellow. Wouldn't he have just stood and fought the first time? Isabella wasn't close enough to threaten his reinforcements or anything. I don't know why he wouldn't have just... Well, whatever. So he has 5 units of stand and fight melee guys. He's got a lot of chariots. We have knights, which are not particularly vulnerable to chariots. He's got some chaos trolls, but we have a Vargulf. Yeah, I don't know. This seems like it should be pretty open and shut. We had to be careful with our vampire, but Dieter over here. Captain Skullface can take care of himself, it seems like. I was so worried. All throughout the campaign, I was like, man, we gotta get Graveguard. We need units that can fight armored dudes. And then here at the end, we're mostly fighting naked people. Naked people and trolls who are too dumb to wear clothes. This battlefield must be very complex. It's taking an awfully long time to load this one. Oh, wow. Apparently, I was at the bottom of a hill. Well, that sucks. I mean, it would be a lot worse if these dudes had ranged weapons. But it doesn't mean we're going to have to climb. Fortunately, as this is Vlad's army, we can start pretty far up here. Actually, we could start over here and not do any climbing, right? Oh, no, the actual edge of the battlefield is over here. Still, though, am I allowed to set up in this really narrow area? Looks like I can't pull my units enough to make them thin enough to fit there. Well, we'll just start on the hillside, that's fine. Yeah, honestly, I don't see any particular reason to do anything fancy here, although I do think that probably the knights should be on the outside of the formation instead of in the middle. Let's put these guys over here. The dogs... I'm trying to figure out what role the dogs even have in this battle. I think all they're really going to be able to do is get around back of some marauders and then attack them in the flank while they're fighting zombies or something. Let's see if we can start with a little bit more power than that, because if we can, we can probably land a fairly devastating AoE spell fairly quickly, getting to start right up in their grill like this. Okay. So... I wish you could just issue orders from the... What do you call it? From the deployment mode. I guess somebody should plan to take on Ilfric Crow Brethren. That's not even a cool name. Who told you that was a good name to have? So that person is lying to you. They do not have your best interests at heart. Right, send the spear guys to tangle with the chaos trolls. Again, mostly what these dudes are doing is holding things in place while the good units get to them. Okay, oh, that's right. Vlad doesn't have Winds of Death. I didn't develop his spells very quickly. Well, that's fine. So she can start casting... Okay, she's not quite in range. These guys don't have marauders, though, right? Not, like, the horse ones? Yeah, they don't have any ranged attacks. So, actually, she can just ride right up and figure out her targeting. And all of you head up this way. And in the meantime, these two are going to walk to this position. Alright, let's see what they do as we approach. Because obviously a purple sun has a lot of potential here. If I overcast it, it has an extended duration. It goes up to 17 cost. Okay, let's overcast it. I'm trying to figure out where I think this bunch of units is going to be. Let's try right here. Okay, and the Varglwolf needs to start advancing as well. Well, the dogs did a good job of getting in the way of that chariot. Alright, so I'm going to have the Varglwolf try to grab these chariots. I'm pretty sure that a Varglwolf can kill a chariot very quickly. Actually, what's the range on... the range on Raised Dead is so short. Let's see if we can get Vlad over here and just cast some Raised Dead around the chariots and maybe tie them up. They're doing a good job of running into the backs of my guys, but I don't know that that's actually valuable for them. Yeah, let's just make some zombies right here. Okay. And then Vlad can take on this unit of Chaos Marauders with great weapons pretty much by himself, probably. I guess Emmanuel's down here. Alright, hold up. What is going on over here? I see low health bars. Knights, retreat. Let's pop Master of the Black Arts, get us some power that we can use for casting invocations. Okay, that's enough. How much does it cost to overcast this? I can't do it right now. It's 6 normally, so it's probably... I don't know, it's probably like in the neighborhood of 10 or 11 if I had to guess. Okay, you're good. He actually did completely defeat that unit of Chaos Marauders by himself. Yeah, I don't know, the chariots seem like they must be okay at combat. Where is my... you? We could do a Doom and Darkness thing. I could Spirit Leech their boss. Actually, let's do that. Spirit Leech this dude. I'm going to have the Chaos Trolls break and go after him. Let's have a couple of people break off and get in on the backsides of these chariots that are giving us trouble. Let's also get Dieter over here. I don't know what he's doing right now, but it can't be important. Something just knocked back the Varglwolf. That's disconcerting. Actually, I'm going to have him hit these guys in the back. Knights are reticent to follow orders. Alright, get him! Force him to pick a target and then hit him in the back. Yeah, the chariots seem to be, like, dangerous. Oh, come on, stop moving and turn. Let him catch up to you. Finish that guy off. There's so many units that are not fighting anything over here.
Noble of the night. Swiftly. Death to the living.
Alright, get those guys.
Understood.
Their leader is fleeing. Get him. No, probably not. We probably should have the Vargulf try to fight something that's actually a danger. We can have the damaged units of unit of knights chase this guy down. Alright, before the battle ends, let's try to make sure this guy dies, shall we? Spirit Leech is pretty cheap, and she is fast on her horse, so... on her Hellsteed. So at the very worst, I think we should be able to catch up to him and Soul Leech him. I just want to make sure he dies. Oh no, we lost a unit. I think we'll be okay. This dude has very little health left. Yeah, she's catching. Come on. Where's that last point of power? Oh, we still have this.
We are the new order.
Okay, there it is. Just wanted to make absolutely sure. I hope that Middenland appreciates what we have done for them. Or Nordland, rather. And Middenland loves us. Wait, Middenland? No. You know what is? You know what's happening here? I'm getting confused for the, I tried playing an Empire game on my own, off camera, and I was friends with Middenland in there. Here we're friends with Ostermark, and Nordland is, like, desperately clinging to our coattails. And Averland, to the south, is repeatedly trying to convince us to enter into binding agreements so that they can make us war with dwarves. I remember now. Thing is, we can coexist with dwarves. They're a little ornery and a little magic resistant, but, you know. I think we can basically intimidate them into following our lead. And if not that, at least impress them with our incredible acts of heroism. Because again, we did literally save the entire world. And it wasn't even that hard. Okay, so we've destroyed three chaos or three scaling armies this turn, and two Varg armies. Is that right? What's the replenishment? 2%. Yeah.
I am glad.
Wait a minute. Did that army not run when I attacked them earlier? I thought that. Okay. Maybe I'm getting myself all confused with other things that happened earlier? I don't think so, but maybe. Alright. Let's get some corruption boosters. Block them. Damn it. It was worth a shot. I mean, it probably wasn't gonna work, but it was worth a shot. Alright, what else can you pick up? Yeah, sure. It wouldn't be the greatest thing ever for Bertha von Karstein to be wounded for a bunch of turns. We do make a lot of use of her. Well, I guess we'll just chase this guy as best we can. Okay, and there's a nice big raised dead pool available. So we'll pull some stuff out of it next turn. Alright, who else needs orders? We still gotta figure out what we're doing with Pierre. Isabella has movement left. Let's move her to the road, at least. Let's stay on this side of the border so we can heal. Alright, so the state of the northern armies at this point is that there's a half stack of horribly injured Vargs in the water. And that's all we can see. I don't think we dealt with all of the armies that we saw earlier. So probably there are still some running around somewhere. Alright, let's figure this out. He's not going to go to Oh no, wait, Altdorf doesn't have a big garrison. You know what? Altdorf has a big garrison when the Empire controls it. And I think it comes from this line. But this line is different for us. So Altdorf is actually not as safe as I have been treating it as. Well, we can march all the way to Altdorf. Alright, we have 2,000 money from having won that battle. We have to upgrade our troop buildings in Reichland as well. We have to be able to like actually fight a war from Reichland. Man, as soon as we get one of our other armies over here. No. What do you mean we do not accept this? You can't come to me and offer me something, and then when I say no, decide that you do not accept that answer. What is this? Oh. Oh, okay. Nordland's army is riding out after those Vargs, and we're reinforcements. Good play. It looks like our regiment of renowned dogs may have perished in the battle. Yet again. I actually really appreciate him doing that. So now they've made landfall on the north side of the river. Again, I guess to threaten Karaburg, but... Okay, here's a new scaling army that's trying to mass up. The Bay of Blades doesn't have quite as many units guarding it as some of the other ones we've seen. Ooh, the Tormentor Sword is cool. Can lock enemy units in place for a while. Alright, Averland is mobilizing an army against the Tower of Crack, which is the thing that we asked them to do many turns ago. Okay, what is going on with my order right now? Characters minus 8. What? Oh. Break my vows. This asshole's discouraging the populace. Well. I don't know what to do about that, really. Vlad von Karstein. I do think it's time for Vlad to head to Reichland. The enemy armies are broken, and now comes the time for great violence. Diedrich the Manslayer, I guess just get better at manslaying. It's another one of those automatically applied titles, which I love so much. Okay, Vlad's not that many turns out. Isabella. As much as I would love Isabella to go with him, we do have to re-secure Dieter Schaffen. Looks like that's the only settlement left that needs to be resettled. So let's cross over to there this turn, and then next turn we will resettle it. Aberash.
What?
Alright. Trivially finish the job here. And burn the tower to the ground. There, how do you guys like it? Now the question is, how comfortable do I feel pushing further? Because we're going to keep having trouble with these guys as long as they have settlements. Each one of these settlements is a serious problem, and we're going to be taking attrition damage the entire time we're over here, due to how incredibly corrupted it is. So I'm thinking that maybe we can't actually push very much further, and he's just going to have to stay back and protect the forts. He could get a little bit of help from Valdakir, but Valdakir is also the only thing keeping approval in a sensible place over here. Really, you still suffer -5 public order from lack of corruption at 71% corruption? That's crazy. So at 71%, the net corruption effect is +2. Alright, let's upgrade Volksgrad again so that we can get walls. If I can get walls on every settlement up here, I'm going to feel a lot more secure. So what else do we need to do? Zoyshank is already building its walls. Oh right, raising something takes away all of your movement, so I couldn't move him back out of this territory even if I wanted to. So I don't have to decide whether or not I want to. Bertha is definitely tagging along. If Bertha could get block army off on, Pascal Abandonato, then that would stop his fleeing right there. Plus, somebody needs to assassinate this enemy captain. So, Valdakir staying where he is. Bruno is staying where he is. We gotta put some money into Erengrad. But upgrading this to level 2 would get us another 500 income, and then level 3 is another 1,000 on top of that. Let's issue a new coordination target here. Maybe it isn't feasible for us to take out the next camp, but maybe we can try to get these guys to do it? I'm just sort of curious if we could actually get that to even happen. I kind of hate the fact that clicking on somebody on the diplomacy menu recenters your map on them. Okay, so you guys are all friends. We have trade agreements with everybody that it is feasible for us to have trade agreements with, including Estalia, who doesn't even like us. We gotta get into a position where we can trade with the Wood Elves. I bet they'd give us a great deal. Okay, it looks like we are actually totally set. So now, we have to break Tilia real fast. And then it's time for the grand climactic campaign. Somebody's gotta put these Bretonians back in their place, which is underneath the ground. And then back above it, but, you know, undead. So I guess he's just running home with all of his armies since our old coordination target disappeared, and he will, yes, I will do that. He's at war with the Vargan Scaling. Good man. Hate. Okay, auto resolve. Come on. One? They lost one guy? I understand they were gonna win, but Jesus. Play a little bit fair. The dwarfs have been obliterated. Okay, Bruno the Lorekeeper. Modifying construction costs even more. Alright, do we have a military alliance with these guys?
Dark days indeed when vampires come.
They are on the list of military allies. So that means that this region is now controlled properly. So how are we doing on provinces? 13. It's coming along. By the way, like I said, I was playing the Empire a little bit. It seems to me like the Empire have much easier campaign goals than the vampires do. Oh, has he been doing all this without movement range bonus. That explains some of it. Okay, the Banshee can't quite get into combat position yet. We would definitely beat these guys, which they know. Alright, well, we had to sacrifice a settlement to do it, basically. Alright, and then he's right next to that settlement, so I imagine he can... Yeah, that's annoying, because we lost a lot of money's worth of buildings. Alright. So we need to upgrade Grunberg one more time, so we need 4,000 plus... whatever the cost of two levels of walls is over here, man. I'm not gonna wait until everything's safe before moving forward, just to be clear. We're gonna attack Bretonnia as soon as it seems feasible to march on Marienburg. Or even Gorsel. We'll probably hit Marienburg first. Marienburg has 10 units in its garrison. Marienburg is a huge financial prize, though. So we definitely want to get that under control. So this region's actually, like, pretty pleasant. I guess it's pretty pleasant because we have an army here forcing it to be pleasant. Even without the military occupation, military presence buff, we have a lot of characters who have a lot of plus public order stuff on them. Alright, so what do we want to do with Aberash? We kind of have to make a decision now. It would be a whole turn of walking, taking attrition, and then we could fight the Bay of Blades. We could probably hit these guys from the water and come at them with full health. Like, march back to our territory and plan to get into the water via the beachhead. Yeah, let's do that, and that way we can spend a turn or two regenning instead of taking attrition damage. I'm going to march mode. I can get all the way to here. Okay, I think we need this. So what do we have right now? We have 1830. And we do need to level up Erengrad as well. We have to generate more money so that we can get our economic engine going properly. Kemperbad is just hemorrhaging public order. I wish I could give this to Ostermark, because I don't really want it. Also, I'm really tired of taking characters' penalties to my public order. We've got to get rid of all these enemy units, or enemy agents. Right, do I want to drive up my... Yeah, I think so. Drive up vampire corruption percentage, and the growth doesn't hurt either. Alright, I think we've finally done it, though. We have eliminated the distractions. Our final goal is at hand. It's gonna be a real pain in the ass to keep all these regions happy, though, and we have to control all of the provinces simultaneously. We should check and see what the deal is with the Wood Elves. Drink of anguish. What is this? You want peace? I don't think I've ever seen that. The Scalings want peace. That means we're doing well, right? We don't take that. If the Scalings want peace, it's because they think we're going to eliminate them. We get to sit here and watch as that guy slowly sails off screen. Stuff's happening in Leoness. How am I still getting messages about Leoness? How has this not been completely eliminated yet? Alright, so... What am I gonna do here? Do we start with Gorsel? And do I need to stay in Dietrichshafen until it has walls? That's a long time. The thing is, if I leave here and it falls and Nordland is able to take it over, that's actually totally fine, right? So, basically, screw this. I'm out of here. I just needed this not to be empty. It's time to marshal our forces. I guess we should try to close this thing up with Tilia, right?
Make your demands.
Are you seriously not going to... All right. I think it would be in your best interest for you to take peace, though, buddy. Things are not going to get better for you from here. Well, we can have Bertha head down this way, like, killing his heroes and attacking his armies where we see them. But I think we really do need her to come with us to Britannia. The thing is, I don't think we can fight Britannia and Tilia at the same time, given that they're on opposite sides of us, and we still have to leave forces in the north and everything. Huh. Is it still the case that he has like 11 settlements? He has 10 and the Varg have 6. Huh. His strength rank is 20, but that means a lot less than it used to, because there's a lot fewer players in the game. Oh, hey, this is a good thing to rebuild. The port at Norden. So, what's up with Prague? Bersenling's camp is still... All this stuff is still destroyed. Volksgrad is probably safe. We could probably move out of Prague. That said, we need to do something about the approval. Right now we have five from our military presence, so we're going to need 3 more approval for this place just to stay even. Or 3 more public order. I guess we'll build public order and income buildings everywhere. It's not my favorite thing to have to do with our limited building slots, but I think it is a thing we have to do. These regions are actually gaining approval. Not being taxed, though. Well, I think it's about the best we can do. So, does Aberash get in the water and head to the Bay of Blades? Yeah, let's do it. Let's do as much damage as we can. I don't think we take attrition here. Yeah, we're not regenerating, but we're not taking attrition. So we can hit the Bay of Blades next turn.
I will not betray you.
Okay, Bruno's doing important work. This is important. Valdekir's good. Pierre is... Well, if we move Pierre out of the city, he will actually regen slower. We can just have him sit for 2 turns, and we'll be all set. Yeah, let's just do that. We'll just let him sit in the city. He doesn't need to be right up against the border. We're waiting on Isabella anyway. Helmgard has proper walls, which is important. And we don't have to worry about, I guess, too much about the Bretonians trying any kind of weird flanking maneuvers on us, because we have a border that is, the southwestern part of our border is where the Wood Elves are. So I know there's a path through the southern part of the Wood Elf Forest, but the Bretonians won't dare to go there. Boy, that is a headache I don't need, man. Huh. I guess the Greenskins totally wiped out all the other dwarves down there. You know what? He's strength rank 2. What are you? I'm not going to take this. But I want to see what the Greenskin strength rank is. Because, I mean, it sort of doesn't matter to me, I guess. whether it's the greenskins or the dwarves to the southeast, as long as they're sensible and will be friendly, like...
Be important.
And I guess it's more likely that the dwarves will be sensible and friendly than the greenskins. Yeah, let's sack that. That is a lot of money. Well, at least we're gaining levels quickly out here. So, unfortunately, casualty replenishment rate doesn't work if you are suffering attrition. So if he's going to be running around doing this, maybe we need to take Darkling Skies. We'll scorch the sky black, like they did in The Matrix. Oh hey, Amelia has finally earned her house steed. That's a pretty good one. As far as steeds go, a hell steed is a pretty good one. Alright, Isabella has a pretty simple turn of just moving toward the conflict. Actually, we can just send her to here, and then the turn we declare on... Wait. What is this border? Oh, this is marking the border between Middenheim and Dietenschaffen, so we can actually be over here and still be in our land. What a strangely shaped region this is. Yeah, so when we declare, she can just go to Gorsel and take it right away. It has walls, but we have large, terrifying monsters. Alright, so you're going to sit for one more turn, and I think... Vlad is going to do the same. Vlad should pull some more units. Probably like a group of Black Knights to replace the Black Knights I lost. And a Crypt Ghoul? We actually are about to start being up against people with horses and armor. So maybe Crypt Ghouls aren't the best way to go at this point.
It is forbidden.
Although, it is also the case that there's going to be a lot of peasant mobs and stuff. And like, even their tough dudes have low armor values. What is your deal? Immune to psychology. They have an aura that makes allies within 40 meters of them immune to psychology, which means we can't fear them. Okay. When we start fighting, we gotta target these guys, I think. Alright, let's... Yep, you're healing for a turn. I already figured that out. Bertha is going to wait for trouble. Does Bertha... Yeah, Bertha damages walls. Okay. It seems like Bretonnia's had a lot of time to set up and seen walls on all of their cities. That's, it's a problem we're going to have to deal with. Mousillon is somehow still standing. It's crazy. But I think, unfortunately, this is the end of the video, but I think next turn is the go turn. So let's get to the beginning of next turn before we stop for the moment. Let's see if anything crazy happens during one of the AI turns. There are beastmen.
That knowledge alone will be leveraged against you.
They're at war with everybody. They would like to be at peace with us. Who's not going to like that? Ostermark won't love it. The Wood Elves won't love it. Karak Ziflin won't love it. I'm confident that we can handle those consequences. Where the hell is Karak Ziflin? Is that... Oh, that's these dwarves up here. Yeah, that's fine.
You seek help on castings.
Join your war against Clan Angrund. Absolutely not. To be perfectly honest, if they had asked us for a military alliance there, I might have taken it. Remember, if they become our military allies, they're... Oh my gosh, they're actually helping. If they want to raise this and save me a turn, that would be cool. Yeah, actually, it looks like we're probably not going to have to raise the Beyblades. So we'll just get back in our ships, we'll coastal raid, we'll... Oh my god, you guys! We're vampire pirates now. The Varg want me to give them money for peace? No. No, we're going to settle this the old-fashioned way. And trust me, I know a thing or two about old-fashioned. Alright, we finished Risen Champions, plus 2 experience for Skeletal and Zombie Unit Recruits. Out of curiosity, does that apply to Raised Dead? Well, I guess I'm not even allowed to look at the Raised Dead pool if my army is full. Here we go. No, it does not. Recruits means recruits. Okay, well, that's going to be it for this video. Come back next time. We're finally going to press the conflict against our greatest enemy yet. And we'll see you then.